Hey everyone, Melcadrien here, and I'm back with more games from the LA game space. This is from the experimental pack number 1, Irrational Exuberance. What this game is about? It's about exploration. Explore, there is no ending. Now, does it mean that there's not a whole lot? Well, yes and no. I mean, look at this. The landscape is using rough polygons. You don't see them. They're sort of like a... Think back of the era of the PlayStation. The first PlayStation. The graphics that kind of looks like. What I see is, it's a sort of beauty to it. Sure that there's a lot of rough edges, true, but honestly, it kind of all works out. Because it is in an alpha. I don't know what this thing does. All I see is that it's just... It makes a lot of interesting, makes it look pretty. It flows around your personal view, and you can just hide the ability from happening by holding down the left or right mouse button. Actually, it's just the left mouse button, apparently. The right mouse button does nothing. The left mouse button is a sort of flashlight, but you don't really need the flashlight that much. Sure, there are some dark spaces, but all in all, you don't really need to look for them. It just provides a little bit of visibility. And I just fell. Now, does that mean I'm dead? No. Well, sorta. What it does is that it just resets you back to the starting position. Now, what I'm doing right now is I'm trying to get to a certain point, because sometimes when you look at stuff, you get perks. When I say perks, I say perks. Ah, that's what happened. I was jumping off at the wrong spot. Yes, you can climb on trees, and the tree branches are pretty standard. Pretty standard in this era. Ooh. They're trying to move. But here's the good one. Ooh. They're just flying around. And we gain an ability. As you can see, there's this tile or square that's now in our field of vision. Now, watch as I walk off the edge. See? It spontaneously creates a bridge for you, so you don't fall down into the nameless void. Of course, you could do that. I mean, there's nothing stopping you. Just look down, and you make a bridge straight to the planet. Now, this is where my exploration stopped before I decided this is a good-looking game. Sure, the graphics are pretty old. I mean, some basic pics, some basic effects, some regular blocks, Some rendered some rendered areas. But all in all, I kind of find this a nice game to just explore. It's not like Minecraft where it is sort of like exploration, a whole lot of exploration. Burying the trees. It's sort of like Minecraft, except it's not exactly sandbox. I guess what you would consider it would be That surprised me there. Now, I'm sure this isn't, well, this is sort of related to, I would refer this to like a game like Dear Esther, where you explore. It's not exactly a whole lot of exploration, just exploration, where you look at things and see the beauty of it. I mean, that giant rock, it's just a giant rock. Actually, from this point of view, it kind of looks like a face. You probably wouldn't be able to see it from the recording because it's all black. But when you look at it from this point of view, it looks like a head. Now, recently there has been some sort of controversy of these sort of games, like, are these games actually games? Because there isn't exactly a lot of gaming. It sort of has the aspects of a visual novel, but at the same time it doesn't. Now, I have an idea of what these games could be, and they could be in that sort of genre. Right now I just don't remember it. Let's see. What was it that I was thinking of considering on calling these? Well, drats. I knew what I was going to call them, but it's just been so long since I read it and came up with the genre that I kind of forgot about it. But yeah, this is sort of a this is sort of a exploration game. Yeah, that's what it is. It's a explorable story. It's an exploring adventure. Ooh. There goes an apple. I think that's an apple. It looks like a flower. It could be a flower. But yeah. I guess you could call it an exploration adventure. Because there isn't exactly any sort of goal that you need to do. All you do is just explore, look around, see the beauty of things. And once all said and done, it's done. There really isn't much to explore once you've seen everything. Still, does that mean it's a bad game? No. Sometimes it's in the exploration, sometimes it's in the story, sometimes it's in the ambience. Sometimes it could be all that interconnected together to make such a wondrous looking game. So yeah, this is... I basically call this an exploration adventure. Or an exploration game. But that's pretty much it for this look at Irrational Exuberance for the LA Game... LA Game Space Experimental Pack number 1. If you're interested in this game or any of the games in this pack, you can get it from their website for $15. So until then, this is Melcadrien. I'm signing off. Have a good day, and happy gaming.